So I'm Mrs. Jemina from Department of Chemistry. So today we are going to discuss about the working of a nuclear reactor. So let's see how does a nuclear reactor works. So the nuclear reactor, so we take the fissionable material uranium-235 into the nuclear reactor, and it is used to produce electricity by a controlled fission reaction. So light water nuclear reactor is, we use water. So water is used as a coolant and moderator. So hence it is called as light water nuclear reactor. So we can define it as the arrangement or equipment used to carry out fission reaction under controlled condition. So here the fission reaction is made to take place in a controlled manner, otherwise it results in explosion. So let's see the working of a nuclear reactor. So this is the equipment of a nuclear reactor. So these are the various parts of nuclear reactor. So we have fuel rods, control rods. So we can see that the fuel and control rods are alternately arranged. Okay, so they are submerged inside the main core, and it is enclosed by a pressure vessel. And there is a coolant which is circulated. It enters at the bottom and leaves at the top. And the coolant reaches the heat exchanger, where it is filled with seawater, which in turn is connected to the turbine, where the steam produced here is used to drive the turbine, which in turn drives the generator, and electricity is produced. Okay. So inside this main core reactor, so the fission reaction takes place in a controlled manner. So the fuel rods, so let's see the working of each component in detail. Okay. So the fuel rods, so as we saw in the diagram, so the fuel rods are inserted inside the main core. So the fuel rods which is used are uranium-235, it's a fissionable material. So here the fissionable material is taken in the form of rods or strips. So usually we take uranium-235 as a fuel rod, and it is made to bombard with a slow moving neutron so as to control the fission reaction that is taking place. So next is control rods. So I will move to the diagram. So we have the control rods which is suspended in between the fuel rods. So you can see that a fuel rod is followed by a control rod. So an alternative arrangement of fuel and control rods. So they are, it is movable. So you can see, so the control rods can be lowered or raised upward. So when I lower the control rods, so in this main core, so the fuel rod is nothing but uranium-235, and neutron is bombarded in this compartment. So the fuel, uranium-235 and the neutron collides with each other, and fission reaction takes place here. So to control the fission reaction, when I lower this control rod downward, it absorbs the excess neutrons which is produced here. So I need only one electron to continue the chain reaction. So if more neutrons are absorbed by the uranium, so the fission reaction takes place very, very faster. So as we know, a single fission reaction will generate lot amount of heat energy. Finally, it will result in explosion. So the role of control rod is, when I move this control rod towards inside, that is when I lower the control rod, it will absorb the excess neutron which is present here, and the fission reaction takes place in a controlled manner. Okay. So when I move lift this control rod upwards, fission reaction takes place at a faster rate. So thereby, by lowering and moving the control rods upwards, I can control the rate of the fission reaction that is taking place in this main core. So let's see the next one. So the control rod is made up of cadmium or boron. So it, as you can see in the reaction, it absorbs the neutrons, excess neutrons, which is liberated. Okay, thereby it controls the chain reaction. So the next is moderator. So the moderator which is used are ordinary water, heavy water. Heavy water is nothing but D2O and graphite, beryllium. So these are some of the moderators that is used. So its role is, so when the neutron, so as I said earlier, our aim is to make the fission reaction to go in a controlled manner to avoid explosion. So when the uranium is made to hit with a fast neutron, and when it again collides with the moderator, okay, so the fast moving neutron, when it collides with the moderator, it loses its kinetic energy. That is, the it slows down the motion of the fast neutron. Okay, thereby the new neutron which is coming out of the moderator after collision will have a slow kinetic energy. That is, there will be a reduction in kinetic energy. So the role of moderator is it slows down the fast moving neutron. So to it enables the fission reaction to take place in a controlled manner. So the moderator which is used are water, beryllium, graphite, and heavy water D2O, so on. So the next component is coolant. So the coolant which is used are ordinary water, heavy water, liquid metal, and air. So I'll get back to the diagram for a clear picture. So the coolant, we have the coolant here. So the coolant is circulated through the main core. So in this main core, the nuclear reaction, fission reaction takes place. So as I said, as a result of fission reaction, there will be lot amount of heat energy liberated in this compartment. So the heat energy which is liberated here is absorbed by the coolant which is circulated. This coolant is water. So the heat energy which is liberated here is absorbed by the water. Okay, and then the coolant is then circulated in the heat exchanger. So the role of coolant is it absorbs the water. Okay, so it absorbs the water which is liberated, okay, from the main reactor. So it absorbs the heat energy and thereby it cools the main reactor core. So the next is pressure vessel and protective shield. So the whole main core is enclosed by a pressure vessel. So as I said, here the nuclear fission reaction takes place, a lot amount of heat energy will be liberated, okay, which is absorbed by the coolant which is circulated. So as lot amount of heat energy liberated and fission reaction takes place continuously, there will be some pressure buildup. So when this is enclosed by a pressure vessel, okay, so it can withstand up to 200 kg per centimeter square of pressure, thereby it avoids explosion taking place. And this whole reactor core is enclosed by a concrete shielding, that is, we call it as protective shielding. Okay, so as we all know, the byproducts of fission reaction are radioactive. Okay, so it produces fissionable products like barium and krypton, which are radioactive. Okay, so this nuclear reactor, to avoid the exposure of this radioactive materials to the atmosphere, so the whole nuclear reactor is enclosed by a concrete shielding. It is made up of concrete. It's minimum of 10 meter thickness, okay, to avoid the leakage of any radiation that is taking place. So the next we have turbine. So the turbine is it drives the steam which is produced. So when you look here, the turbine, okay, so the turbine is connected with the heat exchanger. So the coolant, it absorbs the heat energy and it reaches the heat exchanger. The heat exchanger is filled with the seawater. So it transfers its heat energy to the seawater which is filled in the heat exchanger. That is, it exchanges its heat to the seawater. So a temperature of around 300 degrees Celsius is maintained here in this heat exchanger. So as we all know, the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. So when the water which is filled in the heat exchanger is exposed to 300 degrees Celsius of temperature, it gets converted to steam. That is, it is converted to water vapor. So which the water vapor is sent to the turbine. Okay, so it is in gaseous state, so pressure will be built up here. So the water vapor molecules will move towards the turbine. Okay, so it drives the generator. Okay, so it drives the generator, thereby it produces electricity. Okay, so here, as a result of the fission reaction that is taking place, a lot amount of heat energy is liberated, which is absorbed by the coolant, which is then transferred to the water present in the heat exchanger. It is converted to steam. So the steam drives the generator, which in turn produces electricity. So finally, we get electricity. So thereby, we have nuclear power plants, where fission reaction takes place in a controlled manner, and finally we end up in the production of electricity. So the drawback or the limitation of having nuclear power plants is, as I said, the fissionable products which are produced here, they are radioactive. So the disposal is of main challenge to us. So we need to discard in a concrete barrel deep under the ocean or bury it under the earth. Okay. So the nuclear waste he mentioned here is nothing but the fissionable products which is produced as a result of fission reaction. So they are packed in the concrete barrel and they are either dumped either under the deep ocean or under the earth. So this is about the construction and working of nuclear reactor. Thank you.